What's going on, guys? We're doing a, well, early morning for me, very late at night for some of you, makeup stream. We're gonna be redoing Madden and hopefully get it done this time. If I don't talk that much or that loud, it's because it's like 2 o'clock in the morning here. So. Holding. How y'all doing tonight? This morning. That run game's working. Not a good start.
Going to happen with him with the Jets. Plenty of talent, great mind. side. Back to throw, Smith. And that will be incomplete for Cooper. What's going to be the final play of this first quarter? 3-0 after one on EA Sports. Seahawk football here to start quarter number two, as they've got it with a third down coming up. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. A shotgun snap for Smith.
Nice. Good start.
This is fielded at the 27. A good return there, 17 yards. And the Jets will take over first and 10. Breece Hall helping out this offense for another series. He's over 40 yards here in the second quarter. Been nice and effective for them, hasn't he?
He has definitely been dependable and really shouldn't underestimate what he's getting done here, because anytime you're on a pace that's going to approach 100 yards, you will get some damage in the NFL game.
Now he's leading just a hand to his turtles. That for 16 yards to start the drive, first down.
And this is an example of breaking down a defense, because a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. That's what he's doing, forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
On first down, right back to Hall. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on second and 14. Here's Wilson. Throw left side complete. That's Hall. And he'll get it down to the plate of the 37. That's good for a gain of 6. And third and 8 now. Second quarter. 2 minutes remain. 3-0 our score.
All right, so far so good.
We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando or Jonathan Coach. An analysis of this first half of action. Wilson.
Oof.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field has popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
So scores on their first two possessions with 6-0, so field goal is probably not what they were hoping for.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll score at 25. Seattle's offense coming back onto the field, ready for their second drive. They are still in search of their first points in the ball game, but only down 6-0 as they begin with a first down. Oh, he tries to get it to Metcalf, but it's in.
Look at that.
Turn man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Now the ball now going back over to the Seattle Seahawks offense. They're still in search of an initial first down as they come up here first and 10. Fresh off the pick six, it's Smith. Open man, that's Noah Fay at the tight end. He's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. On first down, Smith. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked off by DJ Reed. And what a return as he brings us all the way back to the 25-yard line. And that now two interceptions thrown in the second quarter.
Back to back, too.
63 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. It is a first 10 at the 14-yard line. Now it's Wilson. This will be caught just inside the 10. And his carry terminated at the 8-yard line. Good stick skill showing the power, but just not much room to operate. Calling a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second down. Now it's Wilson. Steps away to his left.
Almost had it. It's amazing what I can do when I'm calm.
Situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now Gino on first down. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining. Charles, he doesn't seem to be particularly in tune with his receivers, just 2% on the football, but he did seem really locked in before the game.
Yeah, and that has to do with receivers sometimes. Sometimes the defenders knock them off their routes, and you're usually pretty precise. 1, 2, 3 cut, balls out of his hands to the receiver. In this case, it might be all the way out of step.
Shot here before break. Smith. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And he will be brought down. What will be the final play of this first half? So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we get there, you have it. Halftime quickly over. Third quarter, here we go. We welcome you back now, alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon. Set for quarter number 3 here. The Seahawks trailing, but they will have possession first here as we resume action in the third quarter. And he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. Geno Smith getting ready to go again here on offense. And that first half was nothing short of a disaster. 0 points on the scoreboard and a big 3 in the INT column.
So they've got to get him going, obviously, right? So you've got to get
rough start. There we go.
And then you say to him, look at that. You complete 3, 4, 5 in a row. Now you've got to get your confidence going.
On second down, it's Walker. We'll get about 3 up past the 25. Another modest gain there on that one. And I think, Charles, you can probably pin part of the deficit and a failure on their part to really get this ground game established.
Yeah, they've really struggled to be multidimensional in this one, haven't they, partner? Because they have to be extremely one-dimensional now if they hope to get back into this game. They have to do it by throwing the football and hope to have success through the air. Happening here, and it'll lead to a fourth down.
And taken right on the 30.
Nope.
This will be a 41-yard punt, 3 on the return.
I should have just went straight.
We'll take over. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession.
You know, I didn't even do next week's schedule yet. I'm sorry, everybody. I'll have that up soon.
Three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you also not there. You wouldn't turn it off. This is what NFL offenses call 4 minutes from down. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
On first and 10, it's Wilson.
Anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Neither QB's throwing.
They go play action now. Wilson. And that's to the left sideline and incomplete.
Oftentimes when you're losing the game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
Wilson.
Nice. Very nice.
Now Zerline on and the extra point. And that stretches the lead to 27. So that drive spanned 5 plays. And it was capped off by a Breece Hall touchdown run. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Seattle again getting ready to take over offensively. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD. And if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are stuck?
And now the rookie's free. Now he's loose down the left side. And all the way in. Touchdown, Seattle. Jackson Smith and Jigba, 75 yards, and the Seahawks are able to get a score.
They beat me.
The final stages of this third quarter. Myers connects on the PAT, and the lead now down to 20. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession.
Gotta watch those deep passes now.
Despite the score moment, they begin first and 10. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
All right, let's see here.
Set to begin quarter number 4.
We got to get back into playing Diablo too. We haven't done Diablo in a long time. Maybe we'll do that this week. If that's something y'all want to see. Pretty sure we're going to win this.
On first and 10, it's Hall. Takes this to the 32.
136 yards. That's awesome.
After that broken tackle, it's a 7-yard carry to set them up for the second and 3.
He got stopped.
This drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
Zerline's kick is through, and that will extend their lead even further. Sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the three and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so. And maybe you've actually clicked him off in your headset so you can keep calling plays and trying to add to this lead.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. Well, it's been a struggle so far for this offense, Charles. It's not only that they haven't been able to put the points up, but really stringing yards together has been a real issue for them in this one.
I'm so glad you brought up the yards.
I thought they were going to go deep.
Thinking to myself, we've seen a lot of NFL games, and we've seen our share of lopsided contests, but in almost all of them, both offenses have put up at least 200 yards in a game, but not in this one. This has been a display of offense, and frankly, I think trying to spread our fingers wide enough to actually see the result.
Oh, it's out. Smith lost it. Oh, and one of the linemen on the other side has got it. And that will write a finish to this ball game.
Good start. 1-0. Let's see if we can go 2-0. Alright, who we playing? The Bears? Texans. We can do this.
It's the NFL.
Bears and Texans. Let's go. All right, first play of the game. Yo, I gotta clip that. That was wild. Here we go.
15 yards, the Texans pick up the first down.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
And he'll get it down as he's inside the 40. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. Singletary. They'll go up the middle.
Can we get one more off? I got the run game working. Almost. Almost. We're in. Let's go. Is it? And the drive will begin at the 25. Never mind. So here now the Bears offense for their first drive of the game. We going 2-0 straight up. 2-0 from Ohio State, it's Justin Fields. 2-0. I feel it. It's making sure this team knows that there's a sense of urgency, yet somehow still stays calm. Because Fields hit and the ball is loose. And it looks like one of the DBs. I gotta clip that one too. Sorry, I had to clip it. He coughs the ball up, as you noted. So from the 9 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. They'll run on 1st down with Singletary. He's getting like 15 yards per carry here. Easily. That's okay. We got it back. We got it back. Should have got that sack. Oh well. Can't get everyone. Now it's Fields. Oh, come on. They might actually get in. Yeah, they're going to take the three. Smart play. Smart play. All right, give me 1 second.
So we've come upon halftime here in Houston, and it's the home team, the Texans, leading this one. And we'll get you on the line. Standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everyone, to our brand new studios here in downtown Orlando in the EA Sports halftime report. We just have a very good out of the Ohio State man, CJ Stroud. He's got a touchdown pass on the ledger as his guys were able to build a double-digit lead.
These two clubs. Okay, let's go. We're going to stick with the run.
For the call of the second half, we go back out to Houston. H-Town and Brandon God.
All right, Coach, thanks very much. Fine work as always as we welcome you back for quarter number three. Ready for the second half. 14-3 our score as we are back underway on EA Sports. Begin at the 25 as Scott is going to stay in the end zone. And the Bears offense set to go to begin the third quarter. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively. Virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they got some time. The running game struggled in the first half.
We held them.
Focus on defending the pass here.
Now we just got to one more.
Maybe open things up for a comeback here in this
game. Get the ball back and put the game away.
Charles, remember, drive one made it to the end zone. Drive two resulted in a touchdown as well. Now they'll try to make it 3-for-3.
Yeah,
I'm pumped.
First and 10, it's Stroud.
Look at that.
Give up the middle to Singletary. And they
All we got to do is punch it in. We got this game. 2-0.
Back now in Houston. It's the Texans in control of the football and leading this game as well as we start the fourth. Now they'll send a tight end in motion left. Pierce.
There it is.
Time we saw them out there was a quick three and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going. They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
That helps the completion percentage, but not much else, and now it's third and ten. Here's Fields.
Nice. Nice breakup. Nah, I got caught up. Still got a couple, though. We need to get eight here.
Now Stroud. TJ Edwards drops him for a loss of 12, and it also brings up fourth down.
But you just knew that these rushers were eager to do that today. Put him on the ground. Their plan, introduce themselves.
We're going to go for it.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. They're unable to connect, but a late flag comes in. And the contact may have come too early.
What?
Trying to defend the out route there. The PI call.
And you know what's difficult about that one is sometimes you.
I mean, it was a good call.
Move and go for the football, and other times just want to hang on the upfield shoulder and make the tackle.
I can't argue with the call.
They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. Now a first down throw, Fields. And he's going to go down. Sacked right around the 17. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts. As a clock stop with 47 seconds to go in the fourth. Now Fields.
Now we're making them pay.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
Now we're making them pay. Not much. What's going on with you?
No doubt a dominating defensive performance.
Yeah, I don't care what team it is. I don't care who you
play. Damn. Just giving up 3 points in the NFL. I'm just going to let the clock run. I did. I actually, like, four more after you had left. Three or four more. I actually ended up having a real good game that night. Oof, that's gonna be rough. Alright. Not that rough. I'm trying to get the makeup stream in from earlier because I had a lot of computer issues. That's why I'm on this early in the morning. So far, so good. It's on our YouTube archive. I don't think I have it linked in here, though, yet. I have to link it to the page. Good run. Yeah, it was real fun. I'm thinking I actually need to get a new laptop. Unfortunately. Another $700-$800 I ain't got. Come on. Yeah, it was a rough day. Here's Jackson. As he throws there, incomplete. One first down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by the defense to hold things in check. Okay, I can't complain. I'm playing Buffalo, so.
Oh, it's a wobbler here. The special teams mistake there, no doubt. Just 26 yards officially on the line. Yeah, the Bills will take over.
I've been on almost an hour. It's been pretty stable. I'm not sure if it's my laptop or everybody in my house using all the internet, or it could be any number of issues. It's really hard to pinpoint what's going on with it. Okay, I don't think I'm getting 3-0 here.
Back to throw. Allen. That's caught by Gabriel Davis. And he'll take this from 147-yard line to the other. A gain of 6.
No, it's all updated. I have I think it's a memory issue. I had this happen with my old one before I got this one.
They run for the first time with James Cook.
I mean, this laptop is almost 5 years old too, so it's really done its job. I have my eyes on a much better one. Hopefully in a few months I'll get it and everything will go back to normal. Oh, come on, guys. Me too. It sucks when I have to cancel streams and like restream everything. It gets to be hectic and chaotic. Not just for me, but for the followers, the page, my family. Everybody suffers when I have to deal with all this. Okay, we cannot let these guys score. Clipping it. That's a third hit I've seen like that today. Two of them happened to me. Ah, okay. It's like 3 a.m. where I'm at. Yeah, just hit 3. Uh, 24. I haven't gotten 25 yet. I do want to get that in the college football game. Crap. I'm not doing very good this game. Ah, ha ha ha. Come on. They really do. I played the trial for it. I'm more into the NCAA one though. That one I absolutely loved. I can't wait to get that one. I don't know, 25 seemed too easy for me. I mean, I was playing on all pro, and I was scoring pretty much at will. There we go. Scoreless first half. Can't say I've had that happen. I'm just playing regular. I'm playing against a computer. Just regular games. No mode. Just doing random. I picked two random teams, 3 minute quarters on pro. It gives me a decent challenge. You wouldn't think that if you saw the first two games, though. Come on, man. I don't even know what to call that. That was insane. Somebody's got a score here. Ooh. That was rough. I used to. I haven't on this one. Normally on Madden, I do the be a star mode or whatever it's called usually. Superstar mode. I haven't done it on this one. I think this is the first Madden I haven't done it on. I start playing it, I never finish it. Well, this ain't good. This is the first time I've made it to the fourth without any score. This is insane. Actually, sometimes I get lucky. It's really all about RNG on that one. Or whatever. I've actually gotten a couple lucky picks in the past. Alright, this game's got me hyped and nervous at the same time. Because this can go either way. Now I gotta hope to tie or get a touchdown. But still, four quarters without a score. I've never had that happen. Alright, awesome. I appreciate it. No, I saw that too. I saw that happening. I saw that happen. As soon as I threw it. As soon as the ball left my hand, I saw interception. Hey, Buffalo's a good team, so I don't mind losing to them. And I'm only going to lose by three, so it's not a big... Yeah. So it's a victory here for the Buffalo Bills, and not all W's are created equal. I guess that's revenge that the computer threw like four interceptions in the first two games. All right, Jets. Like for real, I just played that game the opposite. All right. Thank you. I try. I do try. All right, so 2-1. Not a bad start. All right, I will catch you tomorrow. Thanks for coming in. Nice. Nice breakup. Gotta stop that run. My God, it's terrible. That just happened. That just happened. Let's watch the replay. That was nice. Got five. Good pick up on first down. A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off. A pretty decent from the 41. Here's second down and five. First run of the game for Jameer Gibbs, the Alabama product. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. Third and six. They are in Got the first. Let's go. I'm not going to get back to the line in time. You know, I do the random teams and I never get the Cowboys. I've noticed that. Almost got him too. I dove too soon. All right, we got this. 3-1. I'm calling it now. Defense is working. I should have threw it away. That was a stupid decision. And we get the ball back second half, so. Let's see if we can catch him sleeping with the screen again. I didn't realize time was that low. We're just going to have to go for the kick.
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. quickly able to punch this one through, and that will extend their lead even further. So a late three there, and that'll help as they head into the break.
Talk about situational football, something they've worked on since the OTAs and minicamps the previous summer. They take care of the ball, get 3 points, knowing they're going to get the ball to start the second half. That's the old two-for-one special to finish things off.
So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game. As we're getting through the break at record pace and right back to football. Third quarter, here we go. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth.
I don't think it's really going to matter what I pick, but... is what it is.
Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone.
There he goes. End zone to end zone. We might do two more games after this, get an even six in. I went backwards. That was stupid. Real stupid. Five for six, not bad. Not a lot of yards, but... We'll keep them out a couple of plays.
Second down, and they go back to Gibbs. And good work there in open space. He's got this all the way down now to the 32. First down for the Lions on a nice pickup of 18 yards.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss.
Nice. Not much in offense, but hey, it's working.
quarter, number four. On second down, it's Reynolds. And he's going to get this pretty close to a first down, stopped at the Panthers 23. Call it a gain of five there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Gibbs will try and pick it up.
Ah, got stopped. I'm wondering, should I just kick it? That's what I was thinking too. They're not coming back in 2 minutes. Oh no. Look at that. I just gave up the touchdown. Still out of reach.
Not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So two scores down, time definitely not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. And the Lions are able to cover this one up.
Nice. So yeah, I'm not sure. I might do one or two games. We'll see. Probably two. Looks like we're going 3-1.
And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. But probably not much that they can do at this point, CD. Down 3 scores late in the fourth quarter. This is going to be a little too much to overcome, you would think.
I kind of feel bad for their QB right now.
Because one team
was clearly better than the other in this one. And while it didn't quite reach blowout status, Edwin knew he was going to win this one well before we got to this stage.
That throw by Young incomplete. Downfield.
You know what? I actually want to clip that. Not like there's much they can do right here. 3-1. Let's go. Okay, Washington. Okay. Well, can't do that again. That's not fair. That's not fair at all. I don't want to go against my team. All right, it's either going to be 4-1 or 3-2.
Coming out of high school, goes to Ohio State, doesn't get a chance to start. Transfers to LSU, not thought to be a top prospect. Ends up the number one pick in the draft and justifies it. Tremendous play, excellent mobility, and leadership off the charts.
Burrow looking to pass. Out to the left, he's got Sample there.
Okay. Just need one. Should have threw it away. That's okay. I'm getting some pretty decent runs against them, and the Cowboys' defense ain't no joke.
Down here before he goes down at the 26. Give him the third down
All right, let's see here. I think it's time to go to the air. Maybe. Almost. Almost. Almost had it. All right, we got to stop him. Capable of winning a championship with his arm and his legs. Meanwhile, Prescott's throw there caught by Gallo. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. I hate having to go against my team. Well, I gave it right back to him. That was just bad defense right there. Oh, come on, man. I knew that was going to happen eventually. No. Oh, my. Yeah, I choked. I choked.
Smart move to throw it away.
Thank God. Screw it. Yeah, no. This was the old NFL record distance for decades, a 63-yard attempt. Give me 1 second. Oh, I don't know why they did that. Not even close. Oh well. Coach cut him short. We'll talk to him post game. We got business to get down to. Third quarter action ready to go. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. Out come the Cowboys now as they'll go on offense first here in this third.
Well, it's looking like it's going to be a 3-2.
Can't win them all. That's all I can say. Still a 2-point game. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. It's been a heck of a game. I can't complain. A 4-yard punt, 5 yards on the return. And the Bengals take over first and 10. It just sucks it has to be against my favorite team. I just can't get anything going with the run. And that doesn't surprise me with the Dallas defense. I don't think I'm going to get it, but hey, you know what? At least my defense is holding up, kind of. This has been straight a defensive game. Again.
Here's Brian Anger now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward
the sideline. And this will be out of bounds at the one here, the 12-yard line. So Burrow and the Bengals down 9-7, 2:15 remaining. Plenty of time here. They've got three timeouts and the two-minute warning as they've got it first and 10. The drive starts with a completion left side. And this will leave them a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
I'm just going to let the 2 minute play.
2 minutes remain, and that's our score differential.
All I got to do is get in field goal range. That's all I got to do.
Possession of the football here as we get your reset. Here's second and a yard. This is Mixon on the draw. First and 10 now. Here's Burrow. Finding Sample. And they work this right upfield across the 45.
This defense certainly had an outstanding second half out of there. I know they just gave up the first down there for the offense. They're hoping that that's something they can jump start with and maybe start to move the ball a little bit better. But it's been tough sledding.
I love games like this.
Left. So all eyes now locked on Evan McPherson. He missed his only attempt earlier. This time he's going for the win. And this one is right through. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have
4-1. Let's go. 4-1. All right, last game. I already played them. Oh, I already played them. I keep getting teams that played. All right, Chiefs, Falcons. Let's do it. Actually, this is one of the games I actually played earlier when the computer messed up yesterday afternoon. So it'd be good to actually redo this one. So this would be the last game for the stream. Either 5-1 or 4-2. Ah, what the? That's okay. Actually, that's how it happened the last time, too. Same play. This taken in at the goal line. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across. I don't know why my headset's uncomfortable. It's driving me nuts. Nice throw. Let's stick with the run. All right, both teams got a good running game. This is going to be an interesting game.
Scored a touchdown Their last time out looking to repeat that in Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Mahomes throw into the hands here of Hardman. And Hardman's going to pick up a Chiefs first down as he'll be brought down at the 38-yard line. Now Mahomes to Valdez-Scantling over the middle. And they'll get him down after a pickup of eight.
He's going to beat me with them short passes. Let's go. Defense held them. Come on.
They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. Maybe just a lack of concentration there as he couldn't haul it in.
And when you're going across the middle like that, you know, he's running that drag route. You are conscious of all the bodies and the traffic in there. But let's face it, if you're going there, you might as well come down with the football and observe whatever else happens after that.
And he's going to handle the Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage, so they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
Here we go, set.
First and 10, it's Robinson. And he finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be second down. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. So we are at halftime here.
That's awesome.
Out in front, as we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach,
okay. We're beating them in passing yards. That's insane.
To our downtown Orlando studios in this EA Sports. We're just about set to get back to it. Both teams making their final adjustments, and we'll head back to Atlanta and rejoin Brandon and Charles.
Okay, Coach. Thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back. For quarter number three.
25.
Out to the 25. The Falcons offense ready to get going to begin this third quarter. Falcons first and 10 here as Ritter gets them ready at their 25-yard line. He'll get it to Robinson to begin the drive. And he'll get this out just shy of the 30.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety of being able to hit people with a run in the pass. But in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit that you might even have been in this game. 62 yards on the ground.
Gonna run some clock. That's all we can do. Not like that, though. Oh, what the hell? Throw the ball, dude. Either way, I'm going to give the ball up. I should have punted. That was stupid. That was a stupid play. I shouldn't have went for it. Good return. My offensive line is just terrible. My offensive line is like killing me.
Two.
Going to try to put the pressure on him. Good call. I made a good call on that one.
Stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. And he is going to have a Falcons first down. And it would appear that that's going to be the one to do it. Again, it's Robinson. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. On second down, here's a keeper by the QB. Oh, no, he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Chiefs. And a big turn.
That sucked. I should have kneeled. I just keep making stupid plays. I do good, and then I make a stupid play. They got 1 shot left.
One final try for Mahomes. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack.
5-1. Let's go. All right, everybody, on that note, we are going to get out of here. I want to thank everybody that came in, the likes, the comments, the shares. As always, we appreciate it. Next week's schedule will be up sometime in the next couple hours. And sorry that we had to do this so late in the morning or early in the morning, but it was a makeup stream and I really wanted to get it done. And I appreciate everybody that came in. And we will see you guys tomorrow.